So I got my scales on my bass drum all the way across. I'm using three now, and if I had the five, I could be even more musical. And there's a lot of patterns that come to mind, really inspires you. And then I got my scales and my toms. When I add them into my rhythms and my patterns, I can be musical with them. That's a whole nother scale. Then I got my scale and my cymbals, which I use them more than just crashes. I use them for catching. I can use them like that. So I use them musically as well. So you got three scales, three tiers of musical sounds, like having three keyboards, if you can expand your mind and your imagination enough. And it takes time with your instrument to do that, to discover those things. Like I did, I spent hours a day, lots of the time of my life, trying to find myself and my instrument. You can do the same. Drums are fun. Drums are exciting. Drums are the foundation of the groove in the song. Now, drums are musical instruments, more than just timekeepers. It's all in your tuning, your concept of sound, how broad you want to take it, and most of all, your imagination and your soul. And then on my snare drum, which is another heart of the body of the beat, I tune it all the way up. Actually, it's unusual, but from working with the band Cameo, from working with a great drummer, Larry Blackman, who taught me how to do this when I started working with him in 82, he used to have to come in the dressing room, bring the snare drum in there, and tune it himself. He wanted the snare drum tuned all the way to the tension rise couldn't turn anymore. And I thought it was very unusual, but when I hit it, it was an unbelievable sound. But at the same time, I got that chakra in my arm, which, you know, wasn't too pleasant either, but I learned to tolerate that because this drum didn't give as much being tightened all the way and maxed out. But if you can tolerate that stress on your arm, if you can live through that, you will have amazing sound on the snare drum that translates. And through the years, I worked with them for 29 years, I've gotten used to it and accustomed to it. And then when I hit the snare drum, you really know I hit that snare drum. You really feel it. It'll tear your head off, you know, so. But it's very important, once again, because it articulates, just like the bass drum sound. And then using my method of tuning, this is what it's gonna sound like once you do those techniques. Here we go. Now, when you speak like that, people listen. They know what that 2 and 4 is. That backbeat is there. So that's what I needed to translate to the audience, because I play the big, massive stadiums. And all the people in the back got to hear that backbeat to know where the groove is. So those tuning techniques will get you what you need to translate your soul. So that's my snare drum. And I use a 4-inch deep by 14-inch diameter as my main snare drum. It sounds deceiving, but if you tune it the right way, use the right heads, you know, you can get a good body sound, as well as the crack on the 4x14, which is why I use one. Because when you're playing in the big stadiums that I play in, it has to translate, once again. So I use something that cuts through the amplifiers and cuts through all the vocals and the pH system that you hear the backbeat of the groove. So that's why I use a tight, short snare drum sound. Now that covers the top head of the snare drum. But also, you have the bottom head of the snare drum. And my technique on the bottom head of the snare drum is similar in that it's cranked up high, but not as high as the top head. I tune it just below the top head, but it's cranked higher than most people would do it. So that gives me that tighter chamber between the heads, and I get that crack that I need. And I also, another element is the strainers. I use a wide strainer. I use 40 or 42 strains on the snares, and I tune them pretty much not totally tight against that bottom head, but they're very close. I just want to hear a little bit of buzz on that, and then the microphone underneath will pick up and translate that, and it'll be just enough. But I don't want it to buzz too much, because of the kind of grooves that I do, the snare's got to be tight and precision so I can get that crack and that tight articulation, once again, sound out of the snare drum. It goes along with the bass drum, which is tight and articulate. Then I can have a conversation with your soul. So there is my snare drum techniques that I use within the strainers, the bottom head, and the top head. And that's how I get my sound, like on This Is It, the movie.